got our first guest of the evening today. We got my man Adrian J.
Die to it. Live my life, live it right. Be different, do different things. Don't do it like he did, cause he ain't what I is. But we can't win. Wait, let's get straight to the point.
That's what it is. I actually met you back in Hamilton for the first time, like some years back. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about jerky days, man.
Hey, baby.
She said what? Oh, yeah, baby. Oh.
Thanks.
West LA.
Yeah,
Hamilton was a dope ass school, honestly. Yeah. It's a lot of cool people from
A lot of creative minds, man.
Yeah, definitely.
I'm actually kind of mad I didn't attend there as a student. I used to have to go there after school, like, just to, you know, kick it with everybody.
You know what? But, you know, it's funny, though. Like, you would assume that you went there, bro.
I thought you even went there, Fairfax. I didn't know where you were.
Yeah,
all the way in by the beach.
No, but it was cool, though, because, like, it was so many, like, kids that came from other schools that always came to Hamilton just to kick it. Like, it was a lot of talent at Hamilton at that time. Like, it was people that, you know, led a movement at that time. You know, people that was, like, doing producing, that was, you know, with yourself with photography and, you know, videography and everything. Like,
shout out to y'all.
Yeah, man. When did you first get into photography?
I first got into photography, honestly, when I was about 8th grade. But I didn't know exactly what I was doing. You know, I just got into it because shit was seemed cool because nobody else was doing it. By the time I got to high school, that's when I really took it seriously. I'm like, okay, I can actually do this. So, like, to where people started to question, like, why you always got a camera?
Hey, but you notice that's where a lot of photographers started off at, you know, like for our generation, they started off just messing around at school, you know, capturing like certain like scenes of the campus and getting kids, you know, off guard moments and everything. That's kind of where like people's eyes like really developed, you know what I'm saying? They vision from like for photography.
Yeah, real shit. But yeah, after that, I just took it seriously and ended up diving into, you know, videos. I worked on my first feature last year, so finally got a credit, first TV credit.
You worked with like a lot of people, you know what I'm saying, like the bros too, like, you know what I'm saying, Rangers, you worked with like Jink, you know. You actually worked with Mila J.
Yeah.
Now, how was that?
Oh, I think you can't stay away.
You know I can't.
Let me guess, that main?
You already know.
You got money on this time, right?
Of course. All
right. They're taking the car! They're taking the car!
Hey, yo! Yo, stop the car, man! Give me my car, bro! Hey, pull the car over, dude!
Hey, yo, fuck the car, though.
Yeah, she's super cool. Super cool people.
That's awesome. So, what was the first video that you shot?
First video. Low key with my older brother, Young Blue. That's when the first time I actually tested it out. I'm like, okay, let's just try to do like a music video. So we shot it at night. Shit was dope and kind of eerie, like a horror film type.
Many might try and describe the handsome flawless. Ripping mics quick to recite and handle all this falseness. Dripping from tricks and Santa Claus is a vanguard canceling targets and my squadron.
I just started researching more, really like testing my creativity and ended up doing, you know, other short films and music videos as well.
Do you see the growth in your editing from like then to now? Like, is there anything advice you would give yourself back then that you're doing now?
Nigga, hell yeah, I definitely see growth. The advice I would give myself to really take time. Well, for any artist, actually, just take time with what you do.
I don't feel shit no more. Baby, I am so numb. Should've stopped a long time ago, cause it ain't even fine anymore. Look what I got into, I don't know what to do.
People take stuff you create and interpret it however they want to interpret it, so you really need to have a message with, you know, what it is you're showing people. I usually relate my editing and my stuff to music and like the lyrics.
Right.
I'm like, okay, do people understand this? Like everybody has, you know, a lot of thoughts and, you know, ideas into what they want to create. They're like, okay, I got this idea, but I don't know if it's gonna work. Let me just try it. You never know what might come out of it.
This was a tale of one lost awkward suburb. Don't give up in time, she'll know you truly love her. See living proof in mind. She made me the happiest man alive. Now she's the best friend that I'll ever have. The very best friend that I'll ever have.
Like, what would you tell photographers now, you know, that are young, that are like pretty much in the same process that you were going through?
Gosh, now it's different now. I mean, I think I would tell them just to really know what they're getting yourself into. Don't do it for the money. Just have a vision.
And then you see, it's a lot of photographers now that's, you know, doing these like shoots with models and everything. Have you shot with any models, like, you know, on that level where it's like, you know, nude art or?
Yeah, definitely. A lot, actually. countless, but yeah.
Okay, so like, what do you like feel like with a lot of photographers now that do a lot of nude art? Do you feel like they really just do it for the art, or?
They just do it for likes.
I just feel like it's kind of being overblown now, like the whole like new art model like thing. Like,
it's all the same. Like, it's different models, same shit, same
place. That's true.
Different, different locations.
Yeah,
real shit. Hey, it's all good. Do you have any projects coming up with anybody for like shoots or anything?
Actually, just finished up the short film Hot Yellow with Romero Rose. That we actually just screened it few times 2 weeks ago, and the feedback that we've been getting is crazy. It's pretty much a short film based on stereotypes within the black community. Light skin or star skin, really interesting. It goes deep into that.
You seem like a player.
How?
I mean, cause you high yellow, and all light skinned niggas is players. And I seen your Instagram. I'm actually surprised you asked me out.
Okay, first of all, why are you stalking my Instagram?
Now I'm just working on my first feature film, which I'll probably be releasing next year. It's called Guardian. It's pretty much about a guardian angel coming back to Earth to complete the demons. So
that's awesome.
That's a mood.
Is there any like way people can reach you if they want to contact you for photos?
Yeah,
or?
If you want to reach me, Instagram, Adrian J Photo, Twitter, same thing. Website, StoryTellerCinema.com.
Well, definitely. You know, we want to just like say, first of all, you know, thank you for your time. You know what I'm saying?
Thank y'all. Appreciate it.
Yeah, and then we definitely would love to have you come back, you know, after a certain amount of time with your projects, you know, keep us updated on that short film, that feature film.
Yeah.
We'll wrap it up with my boy Adrian. You already know what it is. DJ Take Light on the 1s and 2s. It's FreshTunez Radio.